Previously.
Boop.
A trip around the globe.
Mexico.
America.
Poland.
Delivered out of this world results.
You're all right, kid.
Thank you, Joey.
But Mackenzie.
Your sushi's a bit big.
And Sophia.
The quesadilla looks burnt.
Saw their MasterChef Junior dreams.
Good night to you both. Thank you.
Come to an end. Tonight.
Go, go, go. Hurry.
This is a three-legged race.
This is going to be hard.
The competition. Gets much closer.
Oh, God.
And the judges are in for a very frosty fate. Then.
What the heck? Matilda Ramsey.
Gordon's daughter.
Do you want some help?
No.
Reveals a secret.
Basil?
Basil.
Basil.
Ramsey recipe.
He's really annoying, isn't he?
Yes.
I should be in therapy. Oh.
Welcome back, guys.
Hello!
It's amazing that I'm in the top 16 of MasterChef Junior.
Oh, wow!
I'm 9, so it's a really hard thing to achieve.
Good to see you all.
Hi!
When I grow up, I want to be a star soccer player and a chef. Even though I've won so many soccer trophies, the MasterChef trophy would be a much bigger accomplishment, and it would show that I'm the real deal and that I can really, really cook.
Are you all ready for another sweet challenge?
Yeah!
My book, the sweeter, the better.
Yeah, me too.
Oh my gosh.
Tonight, you'll be working with my favorite morning treats.
Yes.
I happen to like waking up to the heavenly scent of fresh donuts.
Oh, yes.
Donut time, baby. These delicious sweet treats are what you'll be perfecting in your next challenge. And lucky for all you guys, I made one for each of you.
Yes.
So, come on up and grab a donut.
Ooh.
I want that one.
I am 10 years old, but I feel as if I've made millions of donuts, because our family are big on donuts.
It's beautiful.
Wait. Right. Now, before you guys have a nibble, we need to see which ones you've chosen, because not all of you are going to compete in tonight's challenge.
For this challenge, we will have three teams of two home cooks. Now, if you picked up a donut that's green, yellow, or pink, you are in play.
Yes!
So, green, yellow, pink, find your teammate. Everyone else, head up to the balcony.
Yes!
I'm really excited about being paired up with Olivia because Olivia is a really good baker and she's a really good chef.
They're so beautiful.
Please, put on your aprons.
I'm with Kwani. And I'm feeling really good because I know that back in Georgia, he sells baked goods on the soccer field. So I'm like, nice team member.
Can you help me with mine?
I'm on a team with Pierce. We're both really strong cooks. So I really think we're gonna rack these donuts tonight.
Now, when you frosted a donut perfectly, it looks something like this.
Wow, beautiful.
This is a perfect donut. Is a flawless glaze with just the right texture and an extra drizzle of frosting and sprinkles placed with purpose.
In this challenge, we want as many donuts as you can frost in just 10 minutes.
You're kidding.
Whoa.
Now, the two teams with the most perfectly frosted donuts will be safe from competing in the next challenge.
Yes!
And there's more than your advantage at stake.
Mm-hmm.
Because each team is playing this challenge for one of the three judges. And if your team gets the least amount of donuts, your judge is getting covered in frosting.
Oh, no!
From head to toe. Now, I like the look of the green team. Pierce with Mikey. You will be playing for me.
Oh, yeah!
Yellow team, Kwani, Benny, you're playing for me.
That means red team, Olivia, Emily, you're playing for me. Get me to victory.
Make a promise.
Now, this challenge is testing a particular skill more than any other.
Ooh.
Your teamwork skills. And tonight, you're going to be working together as one, literally.
What?
Oh!
This is a three-legged donut decorating race.
Oh, no.
I'm like, what the heck? Mind blown.
Why?
Emily, that's the wrong leg.
I'm used to working on my soccer team, basketball team.
That's right.
Oh, but on those teams, we're not, like, connected.
Teams, Head to your stations.
Come on, Mikey, we got this.
It's a race.
This challenge is gonna be tough.
But as a fellow Italian, I can't let my good friend Joe become a human donut.
Joe?
All right, teams, at your stations, you have 100 donuts each.
Whoa.
Bowls of glaze, frosting, and sprinkles.
Red team, do not let me down. Teams, your 10 minutes start. Now!
Go, go, go!
Okay, pass me a donut, pass me a donut.
Grab you two, put in more. You have to dip it in.
Now, this is going to be one on pure teamwork.
I'll do icing, you do sprinkles, okay?
Two bodies and two minds working as one.
Come on, hold on!
Now, donuts, they need that frosting down first.
Okay.
A beautiful inner ring around that donut.
I have a perfect one.
Then that white glaze, just a thin drizzle.
Perfect.
Sprinkles.
And then just the right amount of sprinkles. It's not about overdoing it, it's about creating works of art.
Make it look beautiful.
Give me a donut, please.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Our strategy is communication and consistency.
We have to move over some.
To make perfect donuts, we gotta work on the line. Just like we're in a professional kitchen.
Here, you do one, I do one.
Split the works equally.
Okay, we're doing it! Kit.
Here you go, yellow team!
We won't let you down, Christina!
Do both. I'll sprinkle them.
Usually, I like my donuts perfect. Perfect as my hair. But right now, our strategy is we're gonna try and make as many as possible super fast.
All right, let's go, come on.
And if we get the most, we're probably gonna win this thing.
No, this is terrible.
Skip it in. If we go fast and make the most, but they look ugly, this challenge is not gonna work out in our favor.
Okay, yeah, less is more.
So our strategy is quality over quantity.
Make sure it looks really good.
We're doing good.
So, who's looking good, guys?
Green team are a mess.
No, they're not. Pierce and Mikey are going for a lot of volume.
Joe, we will not let you down. We're getting the hang of it.
Look at these guys. I'm covered.
One, two, one, two.
Look at the yellow team.
One, two, one, two.
One, two, two, one, two. They're communicating, and they're working the way you would in a professional kitchen.
Delicacy, delicacy.
Okay, go, go, go.
Come on, red team, you have to hurry up.
Oh, dear. Red team are not doing well.
Uh-oh. Starting
what
slow.
What is the red team doing?
Go, go, go. Come on. You can't do them all individually. Otherwise, you're gonna go so slow.
Red team, two at a time.
You guys have four hands.
Hey, Gordon, you like donuts?
I love donuts.
You ever have one on your head?
Never.
Sprinkles.
Right, girls, try two at a time. He's trying to save me. Come on, Emily, you're not doing anything. Emily, look at me. Move quicker. Okay. Come on, Olivier, move quicker.
Olivia, okay, go. Let's do two at a time. You do one and I do one.
5 minutes to go.
Come on.
There you go, little by little, guys.
Crap, they need to be sprinkled.
I think the thing that I'm learning
it needs more.
Is donuts are easy to eat, but they're not easy to make.
More.
If you're not gentle, the donuts could break.
What the?
If you just frost too quickly, it's gonna look messy.
Woo! Oh, man, sorry.
And if you don't put enough sprinkles on it.
Sprinkles!
It's not really donuts.
Sprinkle beers!
It looks kind of easy, but it is so complicated.
One tray.
2 minutes to go, guys.
Hurry up! Go, move this way. Two sides, two sides, two sides.
Guys, so red team had a very slow start, but now they've pulled back nice and strong.
Come on, yellow team, move!
Okay!
I feel like it's neck and neck.
Okay, finesse.
The green team and the red team are going faster, but Benny and I are sticking with the same plan.
Perfect.
Slow and steady wins the race.
Careful! Finesse!
Last minute, guys!
One, two!
We need sprinkles, sprinkles, sprinkles!
Olivia, green team's in the lead! You guys have to beat them!
Go, we can do it, we can do it, we can do it!
We gotta get these last donuts, come on!
The other teams are catching up.
Just ice it!
So we start doing 3 donuts at a time.
Go!
Whatever it takes, we need to win.
Go on!
10.
Go, go, go!
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Go, go, move.
1. Stop! Hands in the air!
Nice! Stop, guys! All right, it's time to see which teams made the most MasterChef-worthy donuts.
Please don't go to us first.
Yes.
I'm a little worried that we might have the least amount of donuts.
They look good. They look very good.
But they look really beautiful. So let's hope that our quality wins the race.
Our donuts look amazing. I'm really impressed.
They look good, guys.
This one's no good.
But now the standards are so high, it's either perfect donuts or it's wrong.
The rest of them are pretty good, though.
The rest of them are beautiful.
I still have hope that we'll win. But I know this is gonna be very close.
Mikey, Pierce.
We have a lot of donuts. But sort of the bad thing about our donuts is they're not perfect.
I think they look pretty good.
It's a mess.
No, this one.
That one is
what? Mine. That's perfect.
They're definitely not perfect. But we do have the most.
Will all three teams line up in the front?
So I really think we're going to win.
So the results are in. Red team, you put up 29 brilliant donuts. Good job.
Yes!
Yellow team, you scored 28. Which means, green team, you need 28 or more. You perfected 26!
Yes! Sorry!
I'm sad that I let you down.
Green team, will you please stand over here with Gordon and I and the cheer squad?
But I'm also feeling awesome because it'll be super fun to watch Joe get iced.
Bring on the donut.
Joe, your donut.
Now, before I become a human donut, I just want to remind you all, there was a big theme in tonight's challenge. Teamwork, wasn't it?
Yes.
I'm kind of in a team. Mm-mm. In the spirit of setting a good example, Gordon Ramsay and Christina Tozzi should become donuts as well.
Yeah!
Gordon, Christina, come on, team.
This day just got even better.
Don't worry, we'll remember you guys.
On three. One, two,
three!
Wait, where is it? On three, one, two,
three!
Wait, where is it?
Right now. I've never seen anything like it. A human donut.
Oh, man. Right, guys, we're going to get out of this. We'll see you in a minute.
A minute?
I think you need more than a minute.
Awesome! Red team, yellow team. Because your team made the most perfect donuts. All four of you are safe. Congratulations.
Yes.
And as a special treat, I baked a box of donuts myself for you to enjoy.
Thank you.
All right, all four of you, please head up to the balcony.
Yes.
Thank you, Christina.
Thank you.
Thank you, Christina.
Save me one. Donuts.
Okay, unfortunately, we will have to say goodbye to two of you tonight. And you have a tough challenge ahead of you.
One of the most beautiful things about food is that it really does bring people together. In particular, it brings families together.
Yes.
When I was a kid, nothing beat my mom's apple dumplings. We'd have them every night after dinner, one of my favorite parts of my childhood.
The best cook in my family was my Nona, 97 years old. Still today, she cooks her famous chicken and potatoes in a cast iron pan, my favorite meal of all time.
When I was younger, my mom used to make some of the best dinners I've ever had. Maybe they weren't five star, but they were truly delicious. And of course, in my house now, I'm the chef. And they love everything I make. How could they not? Obviously, best dad in the world and the best chef in the house.
Not so fast, Gordon.
What? Why?
Well, we've heard from a very reliable source
very reliable.
That you're no longer the best chef in the Ramsay household.
Says who?
Says me.
What?
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 What the heck?
Hi.
Oh my gosh. Tilly Ramsay is in the house.
Young home cooks, say hello to Gordon's daughter, star of her own huge hit cooking show in the UK, and already a best-selling cookbook author, aged just 15, Matilda Ramsey.
Published at 15 and has her own cooking show. That is just insane.
What?
When I'm 15, I want to be like Matilda.
Tilly, what are you doing here?
Well, I heard you needed a proper chef to introduce the next challenge. Dad, you're 50 now. I think your days have kind of come and gone. Time for a newer round to take over the empire.
Young lady, you honestly think that you can cook better than me?
Actually, I don't think it. I know it.
Tilly in the house.
There must be something that I make for you guys that you love, right?
Actually, yes, a burger.
Thank you, a burger.
Well, I hate to break it to you, Dad, but I think I've taken it up a notch or two. And tonight, I'm going to prove it.
Show us!
To save yourself from elimination, you're going to be making burgers my way. I'm going to show you how to make my delicious Tilly burger with perfect fries.
Yum.
Watch and learn, especially you, Dad.
Tilly looks like Gordon, but with the long, curly ponytail hair. She's so inspiring because she's only 15. She has her own cookbook,
and she's a really great cook, so it all blends together, and you get Tilly Ramsey.
I'm going to start with the patty. I'm going to season it with salt and pepper. I've made a little hole in the middle because I'm going to stuff it with some delicious mozzarella cheese that's going to melt and be all ooey gooey. It's a really nice hot grill to get great sear marks. So next, I'm going to move on to my mushroom. I've made a delicious pesto. Brush that over the mushroom.
What's the green in there?
Basil.
It's called basil.
That's why no one in this country can understand you, Dad. Next, I'm gonna get my russet potato. I've already cut this, and it's really important that they're all the same size so they all cook at the same time. Got my fries in, flipped my burger. Do each side for about 2 minutes. And then let's move on to the aioli. I've got mayonnaise. I'm gonna put some of my pesto in, and that's going to be put onto my toasted bun. Now I get my hot sheet pan. And put my burger on there and my mushroom. I'm gonna put those into the oven for about 5 minutes. I'm making a nice salad to go with it. I've got arugula, gonna put some olive oil, salt, lemon juice, pepper, and give it a nice toss.
That's the way I do it.
He's really annoying, isn't he?
Yes!
Try living with this for 15 years. I should be in therapy. Burger out. On the bottom of my bun, some pesto aioli. Burger on top, mushroom, more of that aioli on. On top of that, my arugula salad. I like to toss my fries in salt, very finely chopped parsley and pepper. And there we have it. That's how you make my Tilly burger. With delicious fries, like a master chef, right, Dad?
Yes, Tilly. Clearly, you learned from the best. That looks incredible. Getting that burger colored beautifully, getting that cheese nice and liquid and hot in the center. Oh, man. Look at that culinary perfection. Trust me, this is a very tough challenge.
So, you've watched me make my burger and fries, and they are 10 times better than any of my dad's dishes. So now, I am so excited to see you all replicated. Please, head to your stations.
I'm so inspired by Tilly. She's such an amazing cook, and she's only 15. I want to be just like her and make an amazing burger.
You have 45 minutes to replicate Tilly's burger to perfection. You'll find everything you need to replicate Tilly's burger in the equipment room.
Tonight, good is just not enough. It has to be great. This is an elimination challenge, and this will be the last challenge that some of you will be facing.
Is everybody ready?
Yes, Chef!
Your 45 minutes
starts now.
Home cooks, you have 45 minutes to replicate Tilly's burger to perfection.
This is an elimination challenge, and this will be the last challenge that some of you will be facing.
Is everybody ready?
Yes, Chef!
Your 45 minutes starts now.
Let's go.
Let's go, guys. Let's go. Let's go. Bye-bye.
Let's go.
Mushrooms.
Lemon.
Where's arugula?
Burgers are not as easy as you think. It's a lot of stress and it's a lot of pressure to get this perfect.
Let's go.
Make sure those burgers are beautiful, guys. You got this.
Burgers are my favorite thing to cook back in Texas. My family loves them and my friends love them. So I want to make Texas very proud. Okay.
I make a decent amount of burgers back in Florida. I know that my skills for cooking are really good, and I think this burger is going to make me definitely in the top 14.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Tilly, today's objective is for these young home cooks to replicate the Tilly burger. Talk us through.
The key thing is to cook on the burger.
Yes.
It's really important the grill is nice and hot. You've got to get that color on the burger.
Sure.
Low and slow.
And then, of course, assembling the burger. If it's assembled in a bad way, too much mayo on the bottom, insufficient salad, mushroom not cooked quite enough, you could slice this thing, the whole thing could fall apart.
Oh, shoot.
A burger's quite deceptively difficult.
Well, the burger is clearly the star, but I look at those fries. I mean, your fries were perfectly cut, right? Because they need to be crispy and cooked all the way through.
Do these young cooks have the knife skills to execute those fries, which is not easy?
Make sure to cut your fries evenly.
There's a lot of skill, technique, balance of flavor, cook times, and temps involved in this.
Yeah.
Definitely.
30 minutes remaining.
Oh, gosh. Come on, guys!
Remy, have you stuffed it yet? Yeah, make sure it doesn't peep out.
Miss Remy! How's it going, girl? So do you eat a lot of burgers?
Yeah, there's actually a lot of burger restaurants in New York.
Guess what? We know that, because we live there, too. You're not the only one fancy pants from New York.
Yeah.
When you cook a burger at home, though, you're doing it on the flat top, cast iron, on the grill?
Our grill at our house is always broken, so I never really grill burgers.
But you can make a good burger on a cast iron grill or in a cast iron pan in the confines of your own home.
Our family makes a lot of burgers, so I think I've got this.
Okay.
Wish me luck.
Good luck.
Hello, Maria.
Hello.
You look like one of the youngest in this competition. How old are you?
I am 8 years old.
Do you think you have a disadvantage being younger?
I don't mind that I'm younger, but whenever I'm in the pantry, I'm always too short and I can't reach stuff.
Oh, no.
No, but do you think at 8 years of age, you can become America's next MasterChef?
I do think that I can become the next MasterChef because I'm one of the most talented home cooks.
And who's the chef at home? Is it mom, dad, you?
Mostly me, because my mom doesn't know that much, and she's been cooking for the longest, but I've become better.
Right, young lady, good luck.
Good luck, Maria.
Thank you.
Big Evan, what's going on, man?
I'm doing great.
San Diego represents like a real all-American city. You get a good burger in San Diego?
I've had really good burgers. Like, there's this nice restaurant, and it has a really nice chicken burger that I like. But also, I make burgers at home.
Now, your fries look a little bit smaller than Tilly's, yeah?
I think that they're a little uneven.
You gotta nail it. Attention to detail, especially on the cut of those fries. Good luck.
Thank you.
I'm 12 years old. I'm one of the oldest here.
Do you ever cook like this at home with burgers and cheese stuffed in the middle?
Yes, I'm an intern at a restaurant in Minnesota.
Wow.
Wow.
At age 12?
Yes, in there we make the Juicy Lucy burgers. They have cheese inside. A Juicy Lucy is the best. I want to make sure that I do this burger justice.
Right, young lady, we're down to 20 minutes remaining. Come on, Ariana, good luck.
Thank you.
Smells like pesto.
Mikey, nice fries, dude. Very consistent cut.
What's up with that burger? Is it in the oven?
Yeah, I got my burger and my mushroom in the oven right now.
You eat a lot of burgers?
Yeah, we eat a lot of burgers. At least once a week. I feel great cooking Tilly's amazing burger because I am a very experienced cook with smoking meat.
You know what I say, Mikey? Italian guy like you needs to make a good pesto. All girls love pesto. And a macho guy like you, you come charging in with like a pesto recipe, you're gonna slay him, kid.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Good luck, buddy.
Thank you.
So smoky! Come on, guys, get these burgers done! Anthony, can you stop your burger?
Oh, my God. I need another burger. I forgot to shove the cheese in there.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my God. I forgot to put cheese in my burger.
Anthony's on his second burger.
What? What? The cheese inside the burger makes the Tilly burger.
Okay. Anthony needs to start this burger over, but time is running out.
Just over 10 minutes remaining.
Let's go.
He might be going home tonight.
If you don't know the first, second time, trust me, you shouldn't be at this stage of the competition.
Come on, guys, get these burgers done! Anthony, can you stop your burger?
Oh, my God. I need another burger. I forgot to shove the cheese in there. Oh, my God. I forgot to put cheese in my burger.
Anthony's on his second burger.
What? The cheese inside the burger makes the Tilly burger. Okay. Hopefully I have time to make this burger again, because if not, I'm gonna wind up going home.
Just over 10 minutes remaining.
Let's go!
Oh my gosh.
Anthony, how are we doing?
I messed up my burger.
What happened?
I forgot to put the cheese in it.
Anthony, that's key.
I'm kind of just like rushing now.
What are you most worried about for this dish?
The french fries and the burger.
The fries and the burger, they're the two main parts.
Yes, chef.
Is this gonna get the better of you?
No.
Young man, speed up.
Yes, chef.
8 minutes to nail it, you can do this. Good luck.
Good luck, Anthony.
You can do it!
6 minutes remaining. Okay, now, Ariana, confident. She's putting the burger on last. Fries cut beautifully.
Ariana, your fries look great.
Thank you.
Mikey as well, guys.
Yeah,
his
too.
Fries look the most evenly cut and the closest to yours, Tilly, of any of them. And his burger looks like perfection.
Flip side, I'm worried about Camden because he put his burger on a cold griddle. So it's got this boiled texture.
I don't know if he's going to be able to recover from this.
Last 2 minutes, everybody. This is the important part because everything needs to come together at the same time.
That's right.
We got this, guys. We got this.
Come on, guys. Start plating.
Make sure your burger is good enough to keep you in the competition. Let's go.
Everyone, make your plates look beautiful.
If that burger is not close enough to Tilly's burger, you could be going home tonight.
Come on, guys.
Come on.
You can do this. Finishing touches. Let's go. 10.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And stop.
Hands in the air.
Hands in the air.
Nice job, guys.
And now for the most important part. Let's see how they taste. Let's start with Mikey.
This burger's a lot more high-end than the burger that I ate at home. I just usually eat a plain burger with cheese. I hope I replicated Tilly's burger perfect. I think I did, but it's time for the real test.
Right, that looks beautiful. How long did you cook the burger for?
2.5 minutes on each side, and then I cooked it in the oven for about 5 to 6 minutes.
Beautiful, really beautiful. Pink in the middle, cheese oozing out. How long did you cook the mushroom for?
Mushroom, probably 6-7 minutes.
Wow.
That was really good. I think your seasoning was amazing and you cooked it perfectly. And the sauce was also really delicious. Just a little bit too much aioli, but otherwise, flavors, you nailed.
Fries, beautifully done. Seasoning on point.
Thank you.
Something clicked tonight. You're a confident cook, but tonight this is your most confident you've ever cooked, because that is delicious.
Thank you.
It's a three-napkin burger. It's fantastic. Your fries look good, nice and even, good coloring. Your aioli is also really spot on. If I go to New York, I order a burger like this in a restaurant, I'm paying probably, like, $24?
For a burger? That's crazy.
That's not crazy. But you know the good news is for this burger?
What?
I'd pay $24 for it all day long.
Show me the money.
Show me the money. Good job.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Be a bump, buddy. Thanks.
Good job, Mikey.
Thank you.
Next up, Tamsin, please. Thank you.
Back in Florida, we have really creative burgers like this. I cook them all the time with my mom and dad, and so I feel really good about this burger.
Nice. Camden, so visually it looks a bit weird because the pate looks way too big for the bun. How much cheese do you put in the middle?
Probably a spoonful.
Mm-hmm. It feels really soft in the middle. Dear. It's raw, young man. So that looks like it's a beef tartare. Feels really soft in the middle. Oh dear. It's raw, young man. So that looks like it's a beef tartare. It's a little taste on the outside. Shame.
Aioli's nice, but the burger's just a bit undercooked, I think.
Yeah. Unfortunately, Camden, it's way undercooked. It's a great shame. I'm lost for words.
The fries, I think, also need a tiny bit more cooking as well to get them nice and crispy. They're a little raw.
Great sauce. It's the burger that's let you down. Thank you.
All right, Camden.
Good job, Camden.
Good job, Camden.
Don't cry, don't cry.
Next up, please, Ariana.
Back in Minnesota, Juicy Lucy burgers are the main kind of burger we make. So if my burger's not cooked perfectly, that'll be really, really embarrassing, because I've made burgers a lot.
Okay, Ariana. So, really good-looking burger, well-balanced, really nice use of aioli. The mushroom looks like it's cooked perfectly. Seasoned well, the flavor's good, the salad is dressed well. Your French fries are a little bit soggy, but this burger is about as spot on as it gets.
Thank you so much.
You nailed the flavor. That patty is well seasoned. The mushroom's cooked beautifully. Arugula is dressed beautifully. The aioli's delicious. These fries, would love to see a little bit more of them, yeah? A little bit wider, a little crispier, but nice replication.
All right, thank you.
Next up, Avery.
Woo! Woo! Avery!
Take your time, Avery.
Don't sneeze. I won't sneeze.
What do you got?
A Tilly burger with French fries and a basil aioli.
You know what this burger is, Avery? It's hammered.
Okay.
Hammered means extremely overcooked. The rest of it actually looks pretty good. The portobello is nice.
Thank you.
It has good balance. Your fries are a little bit smaller than they should be. Your aioli is quite good. But the overcook on the burger is going to hurt you, buddy.
Okay.
Next up, please, Anthony. You cooked more than one burger tonight. What happened?
I forgot cheese.
So it wasn't a cooking issue. It was a cheese issue.
Yeah, sure.
Don't get a lot of cheese there, though, huh?
No. I think it kind of leaked out.
The burger's a little overcooked. I'm sad that there's not more aioli, but the seasoning of the patty is really nice. Would have loved to see more fries, like that you nailed the parsley, the salt, and the pepper. Not the best burger in the house, not the worst.
Next up, Maria, please, thank you.
Do you think it's cooked right, your patty?
Started cooking it so early.
I didn't want to, like, cook it at the end because then I would run out of time.
Dear, it's so overcooked that the cheese has disappeared.
I think the cheese got a little too overmelted.
That's right. It's big enough to house a family of bats.
I do like your sauce and your fries, but the burger's just a bit of a letdown, Maria.
Fries, nice and seasoned. Sauce, delicious. The burger is way overcooked.
Yes, chef.
Thank you.
Good job, Maria.
Next up, Evan.
My dad and I love to cook burgers together, and it's a lot of fun. But no burger is more high-end than Tilly's burger. I think I replicated her burger really well, but it all comes down to the flavor.
Now, Evan, how long did you cook the burger for?
I cooked the burger for about 2 minutes on each side and put it in the oven for 5 minutes.
Good.
Juicy.
Juicy, exactly that.
Oh, gosh. It looks good.
You've nailed the cook. Let's get that right. I love the fact you've toasted the bun so well because it's nice and firm. Mushroom cooked beautifully. And that's the money right there, the cheese. Wow.
That was really good. I really liked it.
Thank you, chef.
Seasoning's on point. Great caramelization. Pesto with the mayonnaise, delicious.
The fries are evenly cut as well.
The thing about you, Evan, is you're a smart cook, so you listen. And tonight's objective was to copy exactly what Tilly's done. What I changed, more fries, pack it. Jimmy, your basket full, bursting at the seams.
Okay.
But you did a really good job. Well done.
Thank you, chefs. Chefs, not chef.
All right, Evan. From a replication standpoint, this cross-section looks like it checks all the boxes. Now, what's going on with the fries over here?
I was trying to cut them perfectly even, but most of them looked a little ugly.
It says a lot about you. Being able to edit yourself is important. The hardest part about replication is getting the right flavor. You've given us everything that was on Tilly's plate, but what you've really nailed is the flavor, the sentiment, the power behind that burger. Nice job.
Thank you.
Good job, Evan.
Good job, Evan.
The final dish. Remy, please. Thank you.
I have really high standards for myself and my cooking, and this burger does not look good. So I'm really hoping they pay more attention to the flavor than the plating.
How do you rate your performance tonight across this Tilly Burger Challenge?
I did not have enough time to get my sauce on the plate, but I did get it in the burger, and I think I could have added a bit more fries. I wanted to make sure all of them were cut perfectly, so I did not get enough in there.
Right. So the burger looks overcooked, and the mushroom looks undercooked.
What a good amount of cheese in there.
Yeah, a little bit too much sauce on top.
Yes, okay.
I think she's got the seasoning done really well.
Mm-hmm.
Aioli's nice.
Mm-hmm. But burger overcooked, and the mushroom needs to be cooked more. Because if you don't cook mushrooms, it turns the whole burger watery. Fries, a touch crispier. Could have done with a bit more parsley and seasoning. Now, you've become pretty prolific in this competition so far. You've won 2 mystery boxes, so I was expecting a sort of a perfect burger. Unfortunately, it's not perfect.
Do you think this challenge got the better of you, Remy?
Yes, chef. I did not put out my best work.
We agree. Thank you, Remy.
Yes, chef.
Remy, what I'm thinking here tonight is that, like, I'm feeling like you're not so passionate about hamburgers. Did you really put 100% effort into this, or did you just kind of blow this one off a little bit? Tell me the truth.
I've made burgers many times before, so I'm really confident making them. But I think that tonight I was a bit too confident.
Overconfident. You know, Remy, the problem with the MasterChef kitchen and why it's so tough in here is that you can be great week after week, dish after dish, night after night, and bring great food and build your reputation up. And everyone's looking at you. And then one night, you ruin a dish. And you know what? You get your walking papers and you're gone. Hate to give you the tough news, but it could be a tough night.
That was a tough challenge. Burgers may seem basic, but in reality, they are far from it. All of you did an amazing job tonight. Well done. And now we need a moment to start making some very different decisions. But before that, we need to say goodbye to my little nugget, my MasterChef Junior.
Thank you, everybody. I loved meeting you all. Good luck with the rest of the competition.
Thank you.
Tilly is really inspiring to young home cooks like us because she followed her dream and became a junior chef.
Bye, Tilly.
Bye.
But right now, I'm really scared because I know 2 cooks are going home tonight. And the stakes are high for this competition. Let's strike you out, not 3.
All of you did an amazing job tonight. But there were 2 dishes that really stood out as winning dishes. One of those belongs to Mikey.
Good job, Mikey.
But the best burger of the night. Congratulations, Evan.
Listen, you all know this is a competition, and we're gonna have to say goodbye to two of you tonight. So if I call your name, please come down to the front. Camson. Avery. Maria. And Remy.
All four of you have done an amazing job. You guys have been incredible. So, those heads must stay high and their dreams must continue to stay alive. Please step forward. Avery and Remy. Remy, Avery, you two have not come to the end of your MasterChef Junior journey.
Oh, my God.
Back to your stations. Camson, we had nowhere to go with that burger. It was so raw that it was just too difficult to taste. And then on the opposite side of that, Maria, my darling, yours was so overcooked, we couldn't identify any flavor. I'm really sorry.
You know how talented you both are? We're gonna miss you both a ton, but we know that we're gonna see great things from both of you. Keep cooking, keep those heads up high, and be incredibly proud of how far you've made it.
Please, both of you, thank you. Good night.
Leaving the competition, I'm a bit disappointed, but I think this whole experience has been the best thing that's ever happened to me. I've just really gained so much from being here.
Even though I'm going home tonight, one of my dreams already came true. Meeting Gordon Ramsay and Christina Tosi and Joe Bastianich. I have many more dreams stacked up, and I think I can accomplish those too. You can do whatever you put your mind to.
Next time.
These waters must go out on time.
Yes, show!
The junior home cooks run room service at one of the country's busiest hotels.
Where's the American breakfast?
Hurry! This is the hardest shift.
Daddy's raw egg.
You will ever work.
You can't serve that. Throw it away.
As a chef.
And then.
Watch and learn.
A pressure test that lives up to its name.
I'm only 9 years old. What are you thinking, Joe?
One potato, two potato.